Welcome back to Right Machining. In this episode, I got a really good one for you. I'm going to show you how I make these keychains through the lost foam casting process. And eventually, we're going to take this process and we're going to make these belt buckles. Although, be it this is just out of aluminum, later on, they're going to be made out of bronze. This is the current stage that I'm at right now. Although it's a failed belt buckle, a lot was learnt out of this. And it came down to two things. It came down to temperature and how I'm doing the gating system for the bronze to get in, because the bronze seems to flow a little bit different. After creating the program, I took it out to the shop and created a massive amount of these. There would be a lot of experimenting over the next couple weeks, so I would need quite a few. After acquiring a lot of them, and I mean a lot of them, it was time to glue them onto the tree. Now, it's not the tree you're thinking. It's a foam tree that's going to burn away and be replaced with the metal. During this process, I glued them together in teams of four, much like a pumper crew. And for the most part, they did hold together. Now, much like Class A foam takes away the surface tension, I used some dish soap mixed with some water to take away the surface tension so I wouldn't get bubbles when I pour the plaster over top of it. Now, the drywall plaster is pretty thick here, and I later found out that you can pour it much thinner over top. Special care and attention was made sure that it was thoroughly dried before I attempted packing it in the sand. The packing process is quite simple. You grab fine sand, and then vibrate the sand so it packs down. Once the sand is packed down nice and tight, it's as simple as pouring the aluminum over top of the foam and it'll replace it. Care must be taken to make sure that everything is covered. Now, I simply take a recip saw and vibrate it against the side, and you can see how the sand is going down. And I also make sure that the can is covering anything that might be close to the surface so I don't have a blowout. Now the time for the disclaimer. The way I learned to do things might not necessarily be the safest or best practice, for example, using a metal crucible. If you decide to do this, you need to do your own research and figure out what's safe for you. I'm very open to positive constructive criticism. If you have any suggestions or want to throw a comment down below, definitely throw it out there. Now down to the pour. What's not shown in the video is I do put a mask on just before I pour, and I always try to have the wind at my back to blow the smoke away from me. Now what I've learned is this is the critical phase. If at any point you stop pouring and there's no reserve in the cup, you're probably going to have the sand collapse on your art, leaving you with some of the failures that you'll see next. Probably some of you by now have spotted a continuity error. That's right. I've done this a bunch of different times and used different containers to pack the sand in, including plastic buckets, which really wasn't the smartest when I first started doing it. In the end, I turned out a pretty decent product. These just needed a little bit of a touch up, of course, because I am learning how to do this process, and then we move on to the good stage. That's right, digging through the vast amounts of my treasure, I found some two-part epoxy that I completely all but forgot about. And for the record, this is the first time I'm using two-part epoxy, and it was as simple as mixing it 50-50, adding some dye, and then folding it in. The key is to fold it in so you don't get air bubbles. Running down to the drugstore, I picked up some 10 mL syringes, which were conveniently like 39 cents a piece, and saved me a ton of time. Although this is really sloppy the way I'm doing it here, in later videos you're going to see me do a much better job of this. And it's quite a lot easier using a syringe opposed to pouring it in with a cup. In the end, I did fix it up with a popsicle stick, and it turned out a great product. I hope you enjoyed, and hey, don't forget to hit subscribe.
Oh, hey, you're still here. Perfect. Hey, I got a giveaway for you guys. If you remember the IAFF, you probably recognize this here. I'm doing a giveaway, and I'll mail them out to you. The only stipulation is you got to be a member of the IAFF, and I'm going to mail it to the fire hall or the station where you work. Leave your name in the comments below, saying that you want one and which fire department you're from, and I'll mail one of these out to you as soon as I can. Catch you next time. Stay safe.